Hello everybody, and welcome to my TF Nation 2018 vlog video, whatever you want to call it. So here I am. It is now the Saturday morning. I should have started this yesterday, really, on the Friday, really, but I just sort of didn't really get the chance to do it, or the motivation to do it, if you know what I mean. It's one of those things, you sort of get here and then suddenly everything sort of just overtakes you, and suddenly before you know it, the day's gone and you realise you haven't started it, so you think, oh, do you know what, I'll just start it the next day, which is what I'm doing now. So anyway, so it's Saturday morning, I've just had something to eat, I've had breakfast, and so I thought I'd just give a little talk of the reason why I'm here. Now, I actually did say that, if you look up, because my camera's over this side, but the screen's here, so we would. Anyway, yeah, so I actually said I wasn't actually coming to TF Nation this year, and it's only, the only reason I'm actually here is due to, sorry if this camera's moving all around, I'm trying to do my best to keep it steady. Yeah, is down to Jonathan, who actually provided me with a spare ticket, and I'm indebted to him for that reason, because otherwise it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be here. And so, well, many thanks to him, and I'm going to try and get him in this video a bit later, so that'll be handy. Anyway, right, so yes, so I'm here on the Saturday morning. Now, I actually did buy some stuff off Jonathan yesterday. I'll just show you these quickly. Here we go. I got these, which was this fellow, I can't remember his name, is it Daniel? The exosuit Daniel. There's a few other little movie figures that I didn't have, which he was selling. I got a Drift. I think these are the Age of Extinction Drift. I think that one is Age of Extinction. We got the Interrogator Barricade, because I do love Barricade. He was kind enough to throw that one in for free, actually, because I was umming and ahhing over it, because I got the original one. And he just sort of said I could have it, so that was really nice of him. And then we got the Age of Extinction Crosshairs, which I sort of did want. I've got the Last Night one. I don't usually go for just another figure of the same guy, but I thought this was a bit different. But I do like the paint scheme, and it was there, so I thought I'd pick that up. And I thought, do you know what? I never got the Wreckers originally when they came out. Was it Age of Extinction or whatever it was, or whichever film they were in? Might have been the other one now, one before that. But I thought, well, he's selling one, and so I got it. I can't remember if there was any more deluxe sort of scale ones of those. They sort of brought them all out, but in different lines. A bit weird, really. And then we got a few Beast Hunters figures. We've got Ultra Magnus, Optimus Prime. And I cannot remember the name of this guy, but I know I wanted it, and it looks pretty cool. Could be Roadbuster, it could be Bulkhead, I'm not exactly sure. I'm sure someone out there knows. I'm gonna do a bit of research on that one, but it looked damn cool, and I thought that's sort of the one I want for my Transformers Prime Beast Hunters, sort of like a collection, really. So that is it at the moment. I'm gonna show you these as well. These, what I picked up already. Also, I've got my wristbands for Stan Bush concert. Again, many thanks to Jonathan for that. Now then, let's have a look what I picked up already, actually. Yes, off Rudy, I got my free art. Just realised that is actually round the wing, so I've got the camera reversed. So it's probably going to come out back to front on the camera, actually. Which is a bit weird, I never realised it actually done that. But anyway, all right, let's have a look, because these, I'll tell you what, I can't draw the toffees, so... if I can get it out using one hand, which I can't, so bear with me. Now, he has done some amazing artwork. Look at these. These are top-notch. Absolutely really, really good. I love these. Love it. Those. Brilliant. And I think he's done it. He's been given away to quite a few people. And he doesn't do the same artwork to each person, so you can sort of like swap and mix and match and everything like that. And it's a pretty cool idea, really. I do like that. Anyway, right, so there's those, and then I've got a few bits to get signed. We have got, this is for Mike Collins, this is X-Men number 266. Bit of a story behind that one. A long time ago, I actually used to collect this comic, didn't read it, I just needed it for, well, the comic shop that I used to get it. I had to have five titles, but I only had four at the time, so I just picked the X-Men, didn't read it, and I was going to chuck them all away, and then I thought, well, I better check to see if they're worth anything, you never know. Most of them weren't, and then I found out that one had a first print of Gambit in it, so I kept that one. So there we go. And I've got my Megatron's Fight for Power Ladybird book. A very British thing, these, but I loved it as a kid. This one, I did have them all. This was my first one, I'm pretty certain I bought. Well, actually, my mum bought it for me after a trip to the dentist. So I never forgot that book, and I've always still had it. It's a pretty favourite of mine, so I'm going to get Mike Collins to sign that. I've got my Stan Bush ticket. I'm going to get him to sign that as well. We've got my Transfer the Movie CD, which I managed to find. I couldn't find my LP from 1986, and I'm pretty gutted about that. I've done the same with it. I found all my other records, all my other six records that I had, but I can't find that one. So I don't know what I've done with it. I know what I've done with it. I put it in a box somewhere. Thought, that'll be amazingly safe. And now, God knows what I've done with it. I'll find it in 2 years, I think. That's what I've done with it. So I've got Blu-ray edition. I might get Stan Bush to sign that, if he can, because it's tin. I don't know. We'll give it a go. Yeah, I don't know if I showed you that one. This is the other one that obviously I bought this one last year. And I got, it's probably not going to come out, it's going to come out reversed, isn't it? I've got Hal Rail to sign that one. So I've got that. And then the only other thing I've got is a fanzine, which I bought at the time back in 1996. Which has got some nice Nick Roche artwork. So I'm going to get Nick Roche to sign that. I was thinking of chucking those away a long time, but then I thought, do you know what? They're a bit of my history from the dark days of when Transformers were literally dead in the water. So I thought, no, I'll keep them. Because back then there were no Transformers. You know, Generation 2 had finished and there were nothing on the horizon, nothing. They were literally dead. And so the people who made those fanzines kept it alive until literally we were lucky enough to get Beast Wars, and then, as you know, from Beast Wars it just sort of carried on, really. So anyway, so that is my little signings and a bit of a haul so far. I'm just waiting for the dealer room to open now, and I'm going to have a look, mosey around, see what I can get. I've got a bit of money. I haven't got as much money as I usually would like to have taken. That's mainly due to the reason why I actually couldn't afford to come, because I could probably have scraped a little bit to come. I could have got the money for a hotel. Well, actually, maybe not the hotel room, not the amount this one cost. But then I would have had, and the ticket to get here, but then I'd have had no money to spend, which for me is a bit of a non-starter, because I just love buying toys. I mean, I love seeing people, but I do love buying toys as well. And, you know, and then but thanks to Jonathan, I managed to get here, and I've got a little bit of money to spend, so I shouldn't really. I need to get my roof fixed. Anyway, right, so there we go. So I'm going to see you all a bit later. Bye.
Transforming, right? We try to hold that to a different standard. That's also at the bottom of the old Hasbro factory. Those are weird light switches for phones that don't exist that are still lit up.
Weird light switches that don't exist? I'm not sure I follow.
It was at the bottom of the factory, just like a ghost machine. That's the
One of my favorite, and I'll get back to your questions, but one of my favorite Transformers franchises ever was Transformers Animated. So that's sort of right between what was going on with the aligned continuity that you came out and the energy. So how did that come about?
Transformers Animated came about just from the cycle I just talked about, through the Unicron trilogy. There was a style of toy and a shape of toy and a package layout that was consistent. And you always, in the toy business, you have to kind of make a splash, right? So it was time to change up the game. So we wanted to
indeed. The next display case that I needed for my larger power range of weapons things.
His studio series brawl. He's going to try and attempt to transform it now, because I'm not going to.
Worst instructions.
But he still looks a cool figure.
Yeah.
Jason.
Hey.
What have you got?
Oh, you've got car effects.
Overlord.
That's pretty good stuff. That's pretty good stuff.
I was 155 for that, so it's a good price.
No, that's alright,
isn't
it?
But
it
usually goes like
780
quid, so
that's not for a while. I remember you saying you were going to go to X Comic Con a while ago, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Trying to get that.
The funny thing is, when I wasn't prepared to buy it, it was there. When I had the money and was the rear to buy it, it wasn't. So,
I
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Oh, I've gone.
I watched a video of the chip driver.
Oh, wonderful.
And see him yesterday if you want to stand with us.
Is it?
Yeah. Yeah, that's great. That's why I try not to buy things these days. Because, Bumblebee with the two cassettes. Just now with 65 quid. Now.
Thank you.
Anybody who's not got a crowning is a loser. Okay, cool.
Can I take that, please? Yeah, if you've got a tiny bag or something. I'll tell you what, I'll probably get it in here.
No, it's all right. Thank you.